what's really exciting about us living in this day and time is that the Spirit of God actually indwells us. The God who's the creator of heaven and earth, He indwells us. And He is, and just by, because of the fact that He indwells us, you know, He has vested us with abilities, and He wants to do certain things in us and through us. And that is the whole purpose of the gifts of the Holy Spirit. And today we're going to look at the gift of prophecy. Surrounding the gift of prophecy, there are many questions, and you know, why prophecy, what is prophecy, and can all prophesy, and so on. So we're just going to look at some of the basics of the gift of prophecy, what prophecy is, and we will know that what prophecy is not. So prophecy, what is prophecy? Prophecy is simply God speaking to man through man. Our God is a God who loves. God is a God who is so relational. He wants to communicate. He wants to express Himself. So God wants to speak to His people, and He wants to do that through a human vessel. So prophecy is just God speaking to man through man. And as we see in 1 Corinthians 14 and verse 3, that prophecy brings about edification, exhortation, and comfort. So there is encouragement, there is edification, there is building up, and there is also consolation. When God uses people in higher realms of prophecy, or in the prophetic gift or prophetic office, then there is also the sense of direction and correction and warning and so on. But the simple gift of prophecy is actually to bring in edification, exhortation, and comfort. So then the question is, you know, can all prophesy? This simple gift of prophecy, which brings edification, exhortation, and comfort, can all prophesy? The answer is yes, based on Scripture. Because prophecy is God speaking to man through man, which means that man hears, receives the word that God speaks, and speaks that out, or does according to what God's word says. So when we look at 1 Corinthians 14, we see several verses which talk about the fact that all can prophesy. Let's look at verse 1 itself. 1 Corinthians 14 and verse 1, it says, "Pursue love and desire spiritual gifts, but especially that you may prophesy." So the question is, who are called to pursue love? The answer is obviously all. And who are called to desire spiritual gifts? The answer is all. And who are called to prophesy? The answer is again all. So he's saying pursue love, that, and he's saying desire spiritual gifts, but especially that you may prophesy. So this simple gift of prophecy is for everyone. It brings edification, exhortation, and comfort, and it's for all. So that should encourage us that you know, it's not for some special people. In fact, all of us are special people because we are called by God, and God indwells us. So this gift of prophecy is for all. And so let's pray and just commit ourselves to God and say, Lord, use me to prophesy. Lord, use me in such a way that I may receive your word. Father, we thank you that that you choose to indwell us. God, we thank you, and it's such a great privilege that every waking moment, every time we lie down, Lord, you are with us at all times, God. And Father, we thank you that you choose to release your words through us, Lord, as instruments of righteousness. And I just pray today, God, those who are listening, that you will quicken your word to our hearts. May we hear your voice, and may we do according to, Lord, what you instruct us, Father God. May we be instruments of righteousness. May we be vessels of honor in your hands to be communicators of your word, the prophetic word that you place in our hearts. We thank you. We give you praise. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you for tuning in to Living Supernaturally. For more resources to strengthen your spiritual walk, please visit apcwo.org.